Good morning, dear students. Myself, Dr. R.S. Damur, and I am the assistant professor at LD College of Engineering. Today, we are going to learn this improper integrals. In previous lectures, we learned this improper integrals of the first kind. Now, today we learn the improper integrals of the second kind, if convergence and divergence test things. Okay, let's start this improper integrals. For this, suppose we can recall this. These are our topics. My topics is introduction, improper integrals of type 1 and type 2, convergence and divergence of improper integral. From this, we can complete the improper integrals of type 1. We can define this. This is the definite integrals, this a to b fx dx, and this is the definite integral integrations over the interval a to b. This is the definite integral where the domain of the integrations a, b be finite and the range of the integrand be finite on this domain. So it is called the definite integral. Now this, in practice, we may encounter problems that fails are to be both of these conditions. Here we explain the concept of the definite integral to the case where the interval is infinite or this integrand f has infinitely discontinuities in AB. See this. In either case, the integral is called an improper integral. Improper integrals plays an important role when investigating the convergence of certain infinite series. One of the most important applications of this idea is probability distribution. Improper integrals, the integrals of this type a to b fx dx is called improper integral if one or both of the limits of the integrations are infinite. Here say this, both of them or one of them are infinite, then it is called the improper integral. Second thing, this function becomes infinite at a point, this or at the end point of the interval. So at point of, end of the this interval, this integrand become infinite, then it is also an improper integral. So in last lectures we see this type 1 improper integrals. Integrals with infinite limits of integrations are improper integrals of type 1. We can discuss these things. If fx is continuous on interval, close interval a to infinity and open to the side, then this integration a to infinity fx dx, we can find out this integral using this formula, limit b tends to infinity, the upper limit goes to infinity, so we can replace by this upper limit by some number b tends to infinity and a to b fx dx. So whenever we have to find out this improper integral of the first time, and if it is of this type, then we can evaluate integration using this. In our previous lecture, we can conclude some examples using this. The second thing is this, if fx is continuous on minus infinity to b, then to evaluate this minus infinity to b fx dx, so what we have to do this, the lower limit goes to infinity, so I can replace this lower limit by a, so limit a tends to infinite minus infinity a to b fx dx, and I can conclude this using my as it is definite integral and put down this limit a tends to minus infinity. And the third thing is, if fx is continuous on minus infinity to infinity, then I can evaluate this minus infinity to infinity fx dx. How I evaluate this? Because both the limit, upper and lower limit, goes to infinity. So I can divide this into two parts. First part is this, minus infinity to c and c to infinity. So I can break up this interval minus infinity to infinity into two parts, minus infinity to c and c to infinity. So I can evaluate this limit minus infinity to c fx dx and c to infinity fx dx. How I can find out this? So in previous, the lower limit goes to this, so I can find out this by my previous method, and this upper limit goes to infinity, so this previously we can find out this upper limits goes to infinity. So in each case, the limit at finite, we say that the improper integral convergence. So if the limit we got this at finite, then it is convergent. If it is not finite, then we can say that it is not convergent. And the limit is the value of the improper integral. Okay. Now see this. Today we are going to discuss main about this improper integrals. Improper integrals of these functions become infinite at a point within the interval or at the end point of this interval. Then we can say that this is the improper integrals of the second type. See this. If fx is continuous on ab and discontinuous at a, then a to b fx dx. See this. This is the open interval at a and closed interval at b, and it is discontinuous at a. See this. If it is discontinuous at a, so a to b fx dx. This type of second type of improper integral can be written as limit t tends to a positive from this side, the right hand side of this a plus, and we can replace this a by t, and limit lower limit is t and upper limit is b fx dx. So improper integrals of the first kind, if it is discontinuous at lower limit, if this at this limit it is discontinuous, then we can replace this term by whole this term. Second, if fx is continuous on a to b, upper limit is open, then a to b fx dx. If it is discontinuous at b, then how we write this upper limit? A to b fx dx can be written as limit t tends to b minus from this a to t fx dx. So we can replace this b by another variable t, and t tends to b minus fx dx. So both that way we can find out the improper integrals when the upper limit and lower limit at that the function is discontinuous. The third thing, if fx is discontinuous at c and if it is in the mid of this, or the point c is in between a and b, so a is less than c is less than b, so c is an interior point where the function has a discontinuity, and continuous on this a to c union c to b, then what happened? So our interval a to b, for this I can break up this interval into two parts, a to c and c to b. Here at c there is a discontinuity, at c there is a discontinuity, so for this a to c fx dx, how I conclude this, and c to b fx dx, and we know that if the upper limit or the lower limit the function is discontinuous, and the previous section we can find out its limit. So in each case the limit is finite. If this limit is finite, we say that the improper integral converges, and that the limit is the value of the improper integral. If the limit does not exist, the integral diverges. See this. Suppose I can find out this limit. Integrations 2 to 5, 2 is the lower limit, 5 is the upper limit, 1 upon square root of x minus 2 dx. Suppose I can put down this x equal to 2, so this becomes 0, and this integrand 1 upon 0 tends to infinity. So at this 2 there is a discontinuity, so this function is not defined for x equal to 2. So what happened that? So this is the second type of improper integrals, and I can evaluate this by taking the lower limit as a t tends to 2 plus. Okay, see this. This is 2 plus, so I can replace this t by 2. So t to 5, 1 upon square root of x minus 2 dx. So now I can evaluate this integration. I can evaluate the integrations and put down this t equal to 2 into this, and whatever may be the values I get, then I can decide this interval is convergent or divergent and what is the value of the integrations. See this. Square root of x minus 2, what is the integration of this term? You know that derivative of 1 upon x, but this is 1 upon square root of x minus 2, so this is 1 upon square root of x, so square root of x minus 2 raised to minus 1 by 2. So now you know that integrations of x raised to n can be written as x raised to n plus 1 upon n plus 1. So this is square root of x minus 2 minus 2 plus 1. So this is square root of x minus 2 and divided by 1 by 2. Now between the limit t to 5. Okay. Now what is the upper limit? I can replace this upper limit by 5. So this replace this x by 5 in this term. So x by 5 minus 2. So this is square root of 3, 1 by 2. And now replace this x by t. So replace this x by 2 t for the lower limit. So this is t minus 2 and 1 by 2. So limit t tends to 2, square root of t minus 2. What is the value of this? Say this. This is square root of 3 minus square root of t minus 2. And I can write this 1 by 2 as a numerator. Okay. So now I can take this t tends to 2. So what happened that whenever this t tends to 2, say this term, root 3 is the constant term. There is no effect on this for t. But for this, it becomes 0. Whenever I can replace this t by 2, this becomes 0. So what is the value of this improper integrals? 2 root 3. Okay, so this improper integral has a value, fixed value 2 root 3, and it converges. So thus given improper integrals is convergent and the integrand is positive. We can interpret the values of t integrand as the area of the shaded region in figure. Say this. This is my figure, y equal to 1 upon square root of x minus 2. Okay, what we have to find out this improper integral between the limit 2 to infinity. Okay, so this area is nothing but 2 root 3. Okay, see this. Now suppose I want to determine this 0 to pi by 2 sec x dx. Is it convergence or divergent? Okay, now see that we know that sec 0. What is this value of sec 0? 1 upon cos 0. Cos 0 is 1. So 1 upon 1, 1. But sec pi by 2, what is the sec pi by 2? 1 upon cos pi by 2. So cos pi by 2 equal to 0, and 1 upon 0 goes to infinity. So this, for the upper limit, this integrand tends to infinity. Okay. Then what happened that we can rewrite this as a x tends to pi by 2 sec x tends to infinity. So for this 0 to pi by 2 sec x dx, how I write this? Because upper limit goes, for upper limit, this value integrand goes to infinity. So I can replace this upper limit by some variable t, and taking this t tends to pi by 2 minus. See this. So for this 0 to pi by 2 sec x dx can be written as limit t tends to pi by 2 minus 0 to t sec x dx. Now what happened that if you find out this integrations 0 to t sec x dx separately and put down this limit t tends to pi by 2 minus, then find out the values. See this. Limit t tends to pi by 2, and what is the integration of sec x? Log mod sec x plus tan x 0 to t. Now again you can put down this values, lower limit and upper limit. For the upper limit, the values is limit t tends to pi by 2 log sec t plus tan t minus log sec 0 plus tan 0. What is the value of tan 0? Tan 0 equal to 0, and sec 0, sec 0 equal to 1. And what is the value of this whole term for the lower limit? Log 1, so it becomes 0. So this is, say this, t tends to pi by 2 log sec t plus tan t, because lower limit is 0, upper limit I can replace this x by t. So I find this ln sec t plus tan t. Okay, now I can find out this t tends to pi by 2. Okay, to find the value, t tends to pi by 2, 1 upon sec pi by 2, and tan pi by 2. Tan pi by 2, you know that tan pi by 2 equal to infinity, and sec pi by 2. So this tends to infinity. So the value of the integrations equal to infinity. So the improper integrals diverge. Now suppose we can evaluate these things. 0 to 3, 1 upon x minus 1. So in previous two example, what happened that? So it is the discontinuity at 0, lower up, or discontinuity at upper. But see in this example, 0 to 3, suppose I can directly put down this x equal to 0, then there is no discontinuity for the lower limit. Same thing x equal to 3 for this. So this is equal to 3 minus 1, so 1 by 2. So there is no discontinuity on this upper limit and lower limit. But in 0 to 3, what happened? That it contains 1. So whenever I put down this x equal to 1, this is 1 upon 0 and it goes to infinity. So this is the discontinuity at interior point 1. Okay, say this. Suppose I can directly find out this, then it may be the wrong way. So I can put down this 0 to 3, 1 upon x minus 1 dx into two parts, because I know that it has a discontinuity at 1. okay? Because whenever I put down this x equal to 1 into this term, it becomes the infinite. So I must divide this interval 0 to 3 into two parts, 0 to 1 and 1 to 3. So now I can evaluate this 0 to 1, 1 upon x minus 1 dx, where this upper limit, for upper limit, this integrand goes to infinity. And same thing for 1 to 3, for this lower limit, this integrand goes to infinity. So I can separately find out this and this. So I can find out this way. See this, 0 to 1, 1 upon x minus 1 dx. So upper limit, for this upper limit, this integrand is infinite. So I can replace this by some variable t. And let's, this is limit t tends to 1 minus 0 to t, 1 upon x minus 1 dx. Okay. So for this, I know this integrations, 1 upon x minus 1 dx, and between the limit 0 to t. What is the integration of this 1 upon 1 minus x? We know that this is log x minus 1. And put down this limit 0 to t. And this is my limit t tends to infinity, t tends to 1. Okay. Now see this. Suppose upper limit, then log t minus 1, and the lower limit 0, so log minus 1, and mod of this is log 1. So the lower limit is was log 1, and what is the value of log 1? It is equal to 0. So for the lower limit it becomes 0, and for upper limit it is t. So log t minus 1, and t tends to 1 minus. Say this, log t minus 1 minus log minus 1. So this is limit t tends to 1 minus, and log 1 minus 2, so this tends to minus infinity. So this integrand goes to infinity. So this is the divergent integration. It is diverges, and its limit tends to infinity. So the integral is divergent. Now for the integral, we can find out this integral using the improper integrals of the type 1 and 2. And type 1 and 2 integrals, we have to say that the function, the integral is convergent or divergent. But suppose we don't know the integrations, we don't evaluate this integrations, and directly we can say that the integrand is convergent or divergent. For this, we have two methods. First is direct comparison test. Okay, so first method is this, it is known as the direct comparison test, and second method, limit comparison test. There is a two test, for direct comparison test and limit comparison test, to evaluate the integrand or improper integral is convergent or divergent. See this, what is the direct comparison test? In the direct comparison test, what we have to do this, let the functions f and g are continuous on a to infinity, with 0 is less than fx is less than gx, for all x is greater than or equal to a. So we see that the function fx is always less than or equal to gx, and it must be the positive function. Okay, so direct comparison test says that if you know that these things are there, and a to infinity fx dx converges if a to infinity gx dx converges. Okay, so if this function is convergent, its bigger function must be convergent. Okay, so this is the direct comparison test. Okay, and we say that if the gx, a to infinity gx dx diverges, then the smaller one, a to infinity fx dx diverges. Clear? So if the smaller integrations, a to infinity fx dx converges, then the bigger integration must be convergent. But if the bigger integrations, a to infinity gx dx diverges, the smaller integrations must be divergent. Okay? Limit comparison test. What the limit comparison test says that let fx be a positive function f and g and are continuous on a to infinity, and if this limit x tends to infinity fx upon gx, so we can find out this ratios of two functions fx and gx, which is equal to some finite numbers l, then if 0 is less than l is less than infinity, then we say that a to infinity fx dx and a to infinity gx dx both converges or both diverges. See this, again what happened, that to compare this limit comparison test, fx and gx, and ratio of this as limit x tends to infinity equal to some fixed limit L. L must be 0 is less than L, is less than infinity. So we say that this integrand a to infinity fx dx converges, then a to infinity gx dx is convergence. Same thing, both diverges and both converges on the same way. Okay, so we can find out this ratio, and one of the integrand we know that if a to infinity gx dx is convergence, so a to infinity fx dx must be convergent. And same thing, if a to infinity gx dx is divergent, then this integration must be divergent. So this is the limit comparison test. Now see this, evaluate this 0 to infinity e raised to minus x square dx. Now I have to evaluate this term. How I evaluate this? We can't evaluate the above integrals direct because the antiderivative is not an elementary functions. Okay, because directly we can't evaluate, because see this, e raised to minus x square, integrations of this term. So for this I can substitute some terms, and then using integrating by parts again I can put down this. So this process is repeated. Okay, so for this I can only check out that is this integration is convergent or divergent. See this, 0 to infinity e raised to minus x square dx. So I can put down this integration into two parts, 0 to 1 e raised to minus x square dx plus 1 to infinity e raised to minus x square dx. First integrand on the right hand side is ordinary definite integral. See this, this is the 0 to 1, so directly definite integrals, 0 to 1 e raised to minus x square dx. Okay, so I can find out this integrations, but for this second integral, 1 to infinity e raised to minus x square dx, what happened? The second integral, if x is greater than or equal to 1, so I can find out this. How I find out this? X is greater than or equal to 1, so x square must be greater than or equal to x. I can multiply both the side with x, so this is x square, which is less than or equal to x. See this, but taking the negative sign, the inequality is reverse. Minus x square must be less than or equal to minus x. Suppose I can take the exponential power, e to the power minus x square, both the side, e to the power minus x. So e raised to minus x square must be less than or equal to e raised to minus x. The integrand e raised to minus x is easy to evaluate, because for this I can use the substitution and then I can find out this. But e raised to minus x square, directly we can evaluate this, e raised to minus x square, 1 to infinity. How I write this? 1 to infinity e raised to minus x square dx. Limit, upper limit goes to infinity, so I can replace this by variable t, and t tends to infinity. So this is nothing but 1 to t e raised to minus x dx. Okay. Now we know the integration of e raised to minus x. What is the integration of e raised to minus x? This is e raised to minus x divided by minus 1, and between the limit 1 to t. See this, e raised to minus x divided by minus 1, so this is minus 1 and the limit is 1 to t. Okay, so now check out this, upper limit t and t tends to infinity, so this is minus e raised to minus t minus the lower limit e raised to minus 1. Okay, so this is negative negative, so it is positive, so this become e raised to minus 1 minus e raised to minus t, and limit t tends to infinity. Then what happens? E raised to minus 1, it is the constant term, t tends to infinity, e raised to minus t, e raised to minus t is nothing but 1 upon e raised to t, and t tends to infinity, 1 upon e raised to t tends to 0. Okay, so this is nothing but this is equal to e raised to minus 1. So now for the comparison test, what happened? That fx equal to e raised to minus x square and gx equal to e raised to minus x, and for this e raised to minus x I can evaluate the integral. Okay, and it is some fixed value, e raised to minus x, the value is fixed, and as this fx must be less than or equal to gx, so integration of this 1 to infinity e raised to minus x square must converge. Why? Because this gx integration 1 to infinity e raised to minus x convergence, and it has a fixed value, so the lower part must be converges. Okay, so this, the integral 1 to infinity 1 plus e raised to minus x upon x dx diverges or convergent. Okay, so for this again what happened? That I can use this comparison test. How does? Say this. 1 plus e raised to minus x. We know that exponential function e raised to minus x, it is always positive. Positive plus 1. So it must be greater than or equal to 1. Okay. Suppose I can divide this by x. Okay. So this is divided by x. 1 plus e raised to minus x upon x and greater than 1 upon x. Clear? So this is my fx and this is my gx. Clear? Fx must be greater than gx. So what happened that? And we know that this integration 1 to infinity 1 upon x dx diverged. Why? Because we know that 1 to infinity 1 upon x raised to p dx diverges if p is less than or equal to 1. Clear? So by comparison test, what happened that this small integrations 1 upon x 1 to infinity 1 upon x dx diverges, so this bigger integrations must be divergent. Okay, so this is divergent. Clear? Now this integration, suppose we want to evaluate this integrations, is it convergence or divergent? How we check out this? 1 upon 1 plus x square dx. Say this. Suppose fx can be taken as a 1 upon x square and gx can be taken as a 1 upon 1 plus x square are positive and continuous functions on a to infinity. Okay. Say this. Limit x tends to infinity. I can evaluate this 1 upon 1 plus x square. For this, fx equal to 1 upon x square and gx equal to 1 upon 1 plus x square. Fx upon gx. Say this. So this is 1 upon x square upon 1 upon 1 upon 1 plus x square. So this is reverse, 1 plus x square upon x square. See this, divided by x square, taking x square outside from this numerator and taking x square outside from this. So x square will be cancelled and the remaining term is 1 plus 1 upon x square. So this is 1 plus 1 upon x square. See this, when this x tends to infinity, 1 upon 1 plus x square goes to 0. So what is the limit? So this is equal to 1. And now by comparison test, how you find out this? 1 upon x square, 1 to infinity 1 upon x square dx converges as p is greater than 1, because this is a comparison test. In your sequence and series also use a pth series test, or in our previous lecture we can find out this 1 to infinity 1 upon x raised to p dx. It is convergent if p is greater than 1. So by comparison test, limit comparison test, what happened that if this convergent, then the gx must be convergent. 1 to infinity 1 upon 1 plus x square dx is also convergence. Okay, so this is using limit comparison test. Suppose we want to find out this example, 1 to infinity cos x upon x square dx. Okay, how I evaluate this? Is it limit comparison test or the simple comparison test? So for this, check out this denominator, 1 upon x square. So suppose I can take this gx equal to 1 upon x square, then what happened? This cos x upon x square, and we know that cos x upon x square must be less than or equal to 1 upon x square. Clear? Apply comparison test. Suppose this is cos x upon x square, it is less than or equal to x square. So applying the comparison test, you can evaluate this thing. So I can find out this is convergent or divergent. Clear? So this is for you that you must evaluate this using comparison test, because cos x upon x square is less than or equal to 1 upon x square. So see this, 1 upon x square. By comparison test, 1 upon x square. See this, 1 to infinity 1 upon x square. What happened that? This is convergent by pth series test, because 1 to infinity 1 upon x raised to p and p is greater than 1. So for this gx, it is convergent. So it means that cos x upon x square must be convergent, because fx is less than or equal to gx. If gx is convergent, then fx must be convergent. Okay. Now try to evaluate this. 1 minus e raised to minus x 0 to 1 upon x cube dx. Clear? how I find out this? Okay, or which test I have to use this? Is it comparison test or the limit comparison test? I can apply the limit comparison test. How? And how I choose this? Another gx. So this is my fx and gx. Fx equal to 1 minus e raised to minus x upon x cube. So what is gx? See the denominator. You can observe the denominator. So 1 upon x cube is your gx. Clear? Now you find out this limit x tends to infinity, fx upon gx. Limit x tends to infinity, this is my fx, 1 minus e raised to minus x upon x cube and 1 upon x cube. Clear? So this x cube will be cancelled out. So the remaining term is this limit x tends to infinity, 1 minus e raised to minus x. What happened that x tends to infinity, so this is e raised to minus x goes to 0. So this is equal to 1. So by limit comparison test, limit x tends to infinity fx upon gx, what is this equal to? 1. And now what happened that 0 to 1 gx dx, and what is my gx? Gx is nothing but 1 upon x cube dx. So for this, see this, this is convergent because p, what is the value of p here? P equal to 3, so it must be convergent. So this is convergent. And by limit comparison test, what is the limit comparison test say that if fx is, gx is convergent, fx must be convergent, both are the simultaneous. Okay, so this limit t tends to 0 t to 1 1 upon x cube dx, this t tends to 0 1 upon x cube minus 1 by 2 1 upon 2 t square, this is tends to infinity. Okay, so this is convergent. Okay, now this 1 upon x cube t tends to 1 to 1, but here see that what is the limit? 0 to 1. Okay, and for the infinite series, what is the limit? 1 to infinity. So this test is not directly applicable. So what happened that 0 to 1, whenever I have to put down this x equal to 0, then what happened? This must be tends to infinity. So this is the improper integral. So for improper integral, I can use this limit t tends to 0 t to 1 1 upon x cube dx. Okay, now this limit t tends to 0, integration of this 1 upon x cube minus 1 upon 2x square, and this limit is t to 1. Now put down this limit t tends to 0 minus 1 by 2 1 upon 2t square, this t tends to 0, so t tends to 0, this is 1 upon 0, so it tends to infinity, so this is infinity. So by limit comparison test, what we have to say that this integrand 0 to 1 1 upon x cube must be divergent. Okay, so this divergent, so this integrations must be divergent. Clear? So they are convergent or divergent simultaneously. So you must observe that what is the limit for this. Okay, so you must observe the limit. If the you don't observe the limit and directly put down, then you must be wrong answer. Okay, now test of the convergence of this. So what happened that what we have to see this different type of test, two tests, limit test and comparison test. Which test you have to evaluate that? You must observe yourself that where we can applicable the test. If it is comfortable with the limit comparison test, then you can go for the comparison test, limit comparison test, or the directly you can go for the comparison test directly. Okay, now see this 3x plus 5 x raised to 4 plus 7 between the limit 4 to infinity. Okay, now see this here, how I choose this fx and gx? Clear? Because whenever I have to choose fx and gx, such a type that one of the integrations I must know. Okay, and for this I can evaluate directly or speedy count to find out this convergent or divergent. Okay, so for this, see this, I can take this limit comparison test. Why limit comparison test? Because this is easy for me. So this fx can be written as 3x plus 5 x raised to 4 plus 7, and gx can be find by 1 upon x cube. Now see this, why I am taking this gx as a 1 upon x cube or not 1 upon x raised to 4? Is it not a random thing? See this, What is the power of the numerator and denominator? Highest power of the numerator is 1 and denominator is 4. So 4 minus 1 equal to 3. So I can take this gx equal to 1 upon x cube. Clear? Now applying the limit comparison test. What is the limit comparison test? Limit x tends to infinity fx upon gx. So limit x tends to infinity fx upon gx. Now I can evaluate these things. Limit x tends to infinity fx upon gx. See this. X cube, 1 upon x cube, so 1 upon x cube multiply in the numerator and denominator x raised to 4 plus 7. So this is multiplication of x cube. So this is 3x raised to 4 plus 5x cube upon x raised to 4 plus 7. So now taking x raised to 4 outside, both from the numerator and denominator. So x raised to 4 outside, so this is x raised to 4 divided by x raised to 4, so they will be cancelled out. Remaining term is 3 plus 5 by x and 1 plus 7 by x. Now what happened that x tends to infinity, so this 1 upon x goes to 0. Same thing, x tends to infinity, this 7 upon x goes to 0, so this two terms become 0. So 3 upon 1, so this is equal to 3. Clear? So my first condition is satisfied. Limit x tends to infinity fx upon gx equal to some fixed limit 3. Now this, how I evaluate this? 4 to infinity gx dx, see this, equal to 4 to infinity 1 upon x cube dx. Is it convergent or divergent? So for evaluating this, what I have to do this, I can take this upper limit as a t and limit t tends to infinity 4 to t 1 upon x cube dx. So this, say this, limit t tends to infinity 4 t 1 upon x cube. 4 is the lower limit, t is the upper limit. Now I can find out this 4 to t 1 upon x cube. X raised to minus 3, what is the integration of this x raised to n? N x raised to n plus 1 upon n plus 1. So this x raised to minus 3 plus 1, so 1 upon x square n divided by minus 3 plus 1. So this is x raised to 1 upon 4 times x raised to 4 and between the limit 4 to t. Clear? See this, minus 3 plus, so this is equal to 1 upon 4 raised to 5, because t tends to infinity I can put down this upper limit and lower limit. For lower limit 4 raised to 4, 4 raised to 5, on upper limit 1 upon t raised to 5, t raised to 4, so t tends to infinity, so this becomes 0. So this integral is convergent. Clear? So now if it is, this integral is convergent, so by limit comparison test what happened for fx? So fx must be convergent. Okay, so now see this, there's two things you can observe. That first is this, where the improper integrals are conclude, how the improper integrals you can find out this. Okay, you can see that improper integrals of two types, first type and second type. Okay, if two types integrals we can find out that, then we have a method to find out the improper integrals. And second thing, if you don't find out directly, then you can say that the improper integrals must be convergent or divergent, and you can use this two tests, comparison test or limit comparison test, to find out the integral, is it convergent or divergent. Okay, so this is the all about the improper integrals. Next lectures we have to find out the applications of integrations. Okay, thank you.